Welcome to Vlogmas Day 2. So clearly I have a lot of cleaning to do, and I was gonna do that tonight. Okay, first of all, I just posted my first Vlogmas vlog like an hour ago maybe, and I decided to vlog tonight because I don't have anything for tomorrow. Go watch the video, it explains everything. But anyway, so my plan tonight was to clean all of this up, but I've already had a really big day with filming and editing and cleaning other things, and also just being on the toilet with raging diarrhea, you're welcome, and coughing and all the things. So I just don't have the energy. So tomorrow we're gonna tackle this room, we're gonna tackle the kitchen, we're gonna get it clean. But for now, I'm about to make myself some food and go to bed, and I'm gonna give you guys a quick health update, mental and physical health update, in just a minute, and then I'm gonna go and eat my food and go to bed. So plans changed, sorry. Another boring, this is what you waited all this time for. So there's this place in Utah called Whistle Walk, and it's the best Chinese food in the whole world. We love it so much. The only thing I don't like about it is their fried rice or noodles, so I usually get white rice. I just want to show you what I usually get because I'm about to dish me up some. So I get white rice, spring roll. This is cashew chicken, which has a ton of zucchini. And yeah, which I love zucchini, I'm a huge fan. Orange chicken and beef and broccoli. And I usually just take, well, these days, in the past, I would eat this in one sitting and then throw it up. But I don't do that anymore. I can get maybe two or three meals out of this. So yeah. Really good. So I want to sit down a second and give you guys kind of like a personal update on my eating disorders and all the things at the times of the places. So it was either the day after the election or 2 days after the election. It was one of those. It was during the time that we were all stressing out and the world was just being horrible to each other, and I'm not using that as an excuse, but it got so bad for me that I was having like suicidal thoughts. Like, I don't want to exist in a world of people who treat each other this way over differences of opinion. Like, it just doesn't register with me. I don't understand it. I don't understand how anybody can say mean and cruel and hateful things about somebody just because of who they voted for. Anyway, you can go watch all my crying videos about that if you'd like. But anyway, yeah, so one of those days, I think it was the day after or 2 days after, I binged and purged, and I would have told you sooner, but I haven't really been filming and really been uploading much, so I'm telling you now. And haven't had a problem since then. I'm back on track, doing great. So that's a total of four or five mess ups this whole year. That's insane, and I'm very, very proud of myself. So now it'll be December 7th or 8th, I think. No, wait, if it's on the 3rd, so it's it. So December 8th will be 11 months eating disorder, 11 months without my eating disorder. And that doesn't mean 11 months in a row. It means 11 months, and I subtract every time I messed up, I subtracted a day. So the 3rd would have been 11 months, but I've messed up 5 times, so it's the 8th. So. And that's pretty freaking cool, in my opinion. I have to go mail some paintings tomorrow that somebody bought, you know, a year ago almost. I'm the worst. And by the way, if you're the person out there that bought the big, huge oval wave, like blue and white wave painting, will you please message me again on Instagram? Yours is the only one that I've lost track of, like your name and your address. So can you message me again, please? And I'll send that out. But tomorrow I'm gonna go send out Maddie's, hey girl, and get that out there. That's my plan for tomorrow, is to do that. And I also need to do some cleaning up. That's really good. Mm-hmm. I can't believe that I eat this now and don't binge and purge on it. It's so weird. Took me a long time to get to this point of feeling comfortable with Chinese food, because it used to be such a trigger food for me. It's not anymore though, it's really not. Oh, by the way, okay. This is what I can tell you real quick. So yesterday, gotta clean out the dentures. Rice gets in there, you gotta like scoop it out. I'm so gross. So yesterday, I posted my first day of Vlogmas, and what happened a few days ago is Danny and I filmed trying weird food combinations, and I accidentally deleted all the footage, and I'm so sad because it was really fun. It was really funny. And so we were like, oh, we'll just do it again. But then I thought about it, I'm like, then it wouldn't be real. It wouldn't be a real reaction to these things because we've already tried them. We know what we're getting into. So instead, I'm just gonna tell you real quick what happened and what we did try. And then you guys can leave more suggestions if you want in the comments for this, for when we do this next time. So we tried, first we tried peanut butter on pickles because that was the highest requested out of everything. I don't know why, like peanut butter pickle sandwich, or just dipping pickles in peanut butter, or crunchy creamy, all the things. So we ate some pickles and peanut butter, and it wasn't the worst in the world, but it wasn't my jam and it wasn't his jam, but it wasn't that bad, so that's okay. Then we tried pickles and nacho cheese, and it tasted really bad. Like, it was not good. It could have just been the cheese that we had. Maybe we had like a different, like not a very good nacho type of nacho cheese. It could have been that, but it was bad to the point that we both spit it out. It was really gross. And then we tried sherbet on ice cream, which is something my friend, neighbor Paige suggested. Oh, I'm sorry, Paige, you're not going to be able to see our reactions, but it was so good. We put rainbow sherbet on top of toast, and it was so good. Danny wasn't as big of a fan, but he did like it. He was like, why is this so good? Why do I like this? I shouldn't like this, da da da. And I'm over there like, oh, this is like the delicious, most delicious dessert. It was so good. So I highly recommend, make a piece of toast, and when it's still warm and crunchy, put some ice cream or some sherbet on top, and it's so freaking good. And then while we had the ice cream out, I decided to try ketchup on ice cream, because this was requested by someone who was probably trolling me. And we already had the sherbet out, so I'm like, should I try the ketchup on the sherbet? That's kind of weird. I originally got vanilla ice cream to try the ketchup on, because I felt like that would be the only thing that sounded like it might work to me. I don't know, but the sherbet was already out. And so I tried the ketchup on the sherbet. I am lucky to be alive. Excuse me. I'm just so lucky to have survived that situation, because it was disgusting. So disgusting. Danny refused to even try it because he hates ketchup, and I didn't make him try it. He just wouldn't do it. So bad. So then we're like, oh, well, maybe it's the sherbet. Maybe let's put some on vanilla ice cream. So we did that. It was disgusting. It was so gross. It was so gross. Whoever, Hannah, somebody out there suggested, I think you were trolling me. It was disgusting. It was the grossest thing I've ever had in my whole life. I love ketchup. I love ice cream. I love mixing foods together. I was very excited for this challenge because I love doing that. I always mix like sweet and savory or hot and cold. Like I love mixing different opposite things together. So I really had my high hopes for this one, but the ketchup and ice cream, I just think it's a joke. You had to have been joking, Hannah. I forget which Hannah. There's a million Hannahs in our community. So comment below, are you the one that told me to eat ketchup on ice cream? And if you are you serious? Anyway. Okay, I'm gonna go finish this in bed and I'm gonna watch what I've been obsessed with lately, which is Schitt's Creek on Netflix. I didn't even know it existed. My sister messaged me and she's like, you need to watch this. Like, you just have to. Like, stop everything you're doing watching it. Watch it. And so I did. And I'm already like halfway through the second season and I love it. It's so funny. It is so funny. Oh my gosh. So I'm gonna go and watch that. I wanna try and finish it by Thanksgiving so that I can talk to my sister all about it and stuff. So that's my goal. So I've been binge watching that. So I'm gonna go do that and I will talk to you guys tomorrow. And yeah, I love you. And remember forever and always that you're beautiful, you're worth it, and I am too. Thank you for watching. Bye.